thought the poem with the line about the smoke being a huge yellow cat curling around the house, clownish figure, measuring out his life in coffee spoons. He said the idea of bondage made him laugh, conjured up an image of some middle-aged couple thinking they'd been a bit risky and trying to spice up their lacking sex lives with an array of contrived and cliched devices. However, with his mother's apron strings to hand, I can't imagine him saying no. You say you don't feel fully fledged, and crawl back into the room. You're too scared to agree, or disagree, or even think about what you want. You say you're scared of feeling trapped, and lock yourself in your mother's house. Duvet covered in pitch and chilly infants, mixed drinks and a sticky sweet taste of vomit clinging to my teeth. Sea trees of dark smelly moon, man and mangled bondage, cooked the cocks and the paint work. Dead one dog cocoon and sheets smeared with sweat and makeup. Three months later, trudging through daffodils and bug shit, we talk facetiously about having gone full circle. We drag symbolism out of football matches in nausea. We look drugs and battered. I bet her boss rolls around, making me nervous and display the emotional betrayal of something I'd done to him. He cooked for 16 back home, leaving me standing on the platform with a squat on my skin and comb in my hair. Please keep in touch. I couldn't see the point.